Hi, I'm Erin Michos, and I'm a co-author on the guidelines that we just released that was put forward by the American College of Cardiology and the American Heart Association on the primary prevention of cardiovascular disease. So primary prevention means individuals who have not yet had clinical signs of heart disease or a stroke, and we're trying to prevent that first event. So what's new about these guidelines is that it takes pieces from previous documents from the American Heart Association about blood pressure treatment, cholesterol treatment, diet, exercise, diabetes, and really puts it forward into one document focused on primary prevention that can be utilized for clinicians and for their patients. So the current guidelines still emphasize that the most important way to prevent cardiovascular disease is to follow a healthy lifestyle throughout one's life. Additionally, when we're considering about drug therapy for individuals age 40 to 75, the guidelines recommend using this risk calculator put forward by the American Heart Association to estimate one's 10-year risk for heart attacks or strokes. And so based on that, it helps guide some decisions such that if individuals are above 7.5% 10-year risk of a heart attack or a stroke, generally, statins are recommended for prevention. However, what these new guidelines then update is they're more personalized in that they also list a number of what they call risk-enhancing factors to consider when making these statin decisions. So these are factors that wouldn't be in that calculator. They include things like autoimmune disease, HIV disease, chronic kidney disease, having some abnormal biomarkers such as persistently elevated triglycerides, elevated C-reactive protein, lipoprotein little a, a number of things. So when these risk-enhancing factors are present, this may strengthen the decision to initiate a statin, or if somebody is on a statin, it may prompt you to consider intensifying the therapy a little further. But additionally, these new guidelines recognize that in many cases, the decision to treat with a statin is still uncertain. And so when there is uncertainty, sort of for a tiebreaker, the guidelines recommend using a coronary artery calcium score. This is obtained by a cardiac CT. And so for individuals who have a calcium score of zero, so no evidence of calcified plaque in their heart arteries, generally they're at low enough risk over the next 5 to 10 years that statin therapy can be deferred or postponed if patients don't want to take it. On the other hand, if there is a significant calcified plaque, such as a coronary calcium score greater than 100 or above the 75th percentile for one's age, that would further strengthen the recommendation that statins would be recommended. So the guidelines recommend estimating risk and then personalizing it to make treatment decisions. Additionally, they also say that individuals who have diabetes should recommend a statin sort of regardless of what their 10-year risk is, and also individuals who have really high LDL cholesterol above 190 would be recommended for statin. So what else is new is sort of that aspirin actually got a little bit of a de-emphasize in the current guidelines. So keep in mind that these are for primary prevention, so the guidelines don't change recommendation for people who have known heart disease. So if you've had a heart attack or you've had a coronary stent, aspirin is still recommended. But in the current guidelines, they indicate, based on some recent trials and the overall evidence, that most healthy people, aspirin therapy is not routinely recommended for prevention. The risk of bleeding may outweigh any benefits. And so most individuals who are healthy don't need to take an aspirin for prevention, but it still may be considered in select high-risk individuals after discussion with one's doctor. So in sum, these guidelines really synthesize, you know, previous documents that were put forward and tries to put it all together to help clinicians and their patients prevent that very first heart attack or stroke event. Thank you.